I greet the fathers in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. The preachers of the word,
our brothers in the Lord
Jesus,
our brothers in the Lord,
our
sisters in the Lord, in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus.
Our granny in the mighty, we greet our granny in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus. Amen. We greet our little ones in the mighty name of our Lord Jesus Christ.
Amen.
Amen.
This is the day the Lord has made. And he says we must rejoice and be glad on his feet. Hallelujah.
Amen. It's the day that the Lord has set apart. He has set it apart.
Because it is so very much important to move us for closer to Him.
That is why in the beginning, when he created the earth,
he made this special day for me and you.
Knowing that this day is the day that we will be corrected.
In instruction about this day. Instruction and manga pa mang. Not anything must be done on this day.
Instruction was is that not everything must be done.
Because as it's a holiday. Not the holiday
holiday. We are
fighting to make spring cleaning go malaping arena.
It's not the day that we have to make spring cleaning in our houses.
But it's a holy day.
It's a holy day.
The day that we must be holy when we come in His presence. Anything.
When he commanded the children of Israelites, he told them they mustn't do anything on this day.
But as we can see now, this present generation, they don't take this date into consideration.
It's not respected. Other people, they don't know even the true meaning of this day. They do their own things. They go to taverns. They do their everyday work this day.
Not knowing that it's actually a little.
Not knowing one day that we will answer in front of God. Our God sees everything we do. Nothing is hidden in His sight. The Bible says the eyes of God are running all over and are looking at us.
So, they do whatever they do.
People who do not know knowledge about this day, they do anything they want to do.
Even the Baba eating, but they become ignorant about it.
Even those others they know, but they become ignorant about this day.
Because they lack the fear of the Lord.
Because they lack fear of God.
We
are in a terrible time. We are in the time where God is preparing us. Preparing us through the word. The word is the one that shape a person.
And then
the The word of God doesn't come normal.
Lentswe la Modimo le bogale.
The word of God is sharp.
Le tlhaba pelo.
It's sharper.
Lentswe la Modimo la tlhaba le tlhaba pelo.
The word of God pierces the heart.
Ke ka mo mopeledi are ilizwi la ihlaba inhliziyo yami.
There's a song that says the word pierced my heart.
La ngibonisa ukuduka kwami.
And show me how much have I fallen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Ke tshaka bletso la modimo le re keke le tshwana le le rumo le le tlhaba.
The word of God is like a sword.
And no gore he penetrate inside their heart.
When it penetrates inside our hearts,
it deals with the conscience of a man.
That is why most of the time when we are inside the church, when pastors are preaching the word of God here, and when it arrives in your heart, it pierces you. There is the other spirit that will fight the word of God inside you. And you'll answer inside your heart.
Fighting the word of God.
Fighting the word of God.
And not knowing that you are not fighting that word, you are fighting God Himself. Because God wants each and every man to be transformed. To be transformed by the word of God. Not by our own strength. Not by our own mind. But by the word of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Because the word of God is the light unto the man. It is the light that takes you to the kingdom of God. Hallelujah.
Amen.
That is why it is so sharp. Why we see the arrow, it has a sharp edge. Because where it goes, it must penetrate. Even the word of God, it must penetrate inside our hearts. If the word of God does not penetrate inside your heart, ask you one question. Ask yourself one question. Does it work inside of me, or do I have any demons in my heart that rejects the word of God? And by then you might be troubled about that. I remember last time the Holy Spirit reminded me of this words that the pastor spoke here in the pulpit.
I remember
the pastor says a lot of things have been spoken in this place. The word of God has been preached with all angles. But we should ask ourselves, are we doing what the Lord is saying when we come out of this place?
And
it troubled me so much. And I repented unto the Lord. Lord, forgive me for each and every word that I didn't do after hearing the word in the tent.
The word of God is alive. The word of God is alive. It's life into our lives.
I'm not standing here talking without an experience.
I saw the word of God in my life changing me. Oh, I mean, I give
Mama Lungile.
Mama Lungile.
Give Nazon 7 Katulo.
On Nazon 7 Katulo.
I'm a younger sister to Pastor Moyema. And I'm so grateful. I thank the Lord. Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
The word of God found me when I was far. I was a sinner, deep in sin. I was loving the things of this world so much. My heart was far from Jesus. I love the Lord Jesus so
much.
Because of his unfailing love. We heard the teaching of last
week.
The word of God says there is those that God gives mercy to those he loves. He has those ones he has mercy. And he loves them and he chose them.
So troubled.
When we walk in on this road and not being troubled. Just coming here and saying, no, we are going to worship and listen to the word and not there is no trouble inside of us.
We are causing a great delay kamo hara kama pelo arena.
I was loving the things of this world, not caring about Jesus. I was living a sinner's life. I was deep in sin. I was loving friends so much. When I was working, I was with this group of colleagues and we were always entertaining ourselves. Every week we are thinking, what are we going to do this weekend? Where are we going? There was no style that I didn't know. When there is a song, I will be jiving.
Hey, neke jaifa, what is it?
I was making devil happy. Jiving all the time. When it's the place is full and I see that people they don't recognize me, I'll take the chair and jive on top of the chair.
I will trample on top of that door.
And
they will embrace me. They will embrace me. Get answer but your back.
But I'm cool. Zavan tavela.
Oh, pana bamu tibu. Why did you come to lengata le makata?
I was out of the way.
Kile muti rati because not humble.
Deep in sin, not respecting.
Why did you kena lele nyato? Kita cha kena lidi jealousy. Oh, why to go?
Undermining people, I was full of jealousy, not respecting. Not even respecting my husband. I wanted my husband to hear from me all the time. I loved attention so much.
Lady appear, appear, the bogate. Why to give lady extensions? I get the makeup here. What is that name for Arubina?
When I'm wearing my trousers and my hair extension and makeup, I wanted to be nice. But God was watching. God was watching. Jesus was watching me and his heart was bleeding. I thank God's love in my life.
Inside of me.
I thank God for the seed that planted inside of my heart. Even when I was in sin,
then
transformation came in my life. God started showing himself in my life. I wasn't understanding what is happening with my life. But But it was God delivering me in the things of the world. Even today, Lord Jesus, God freed me under the power of sin. I started telling my friends. I tell them goodbye, my friends. I tell my co-workers goodbye. I tell the world goodbye. I tell all the evil things goodbye. I tell the boyfriend goodbye. And I told everything evil goodbye. Today I stand here and praise God and say I'm a child of God.
I do it because any conscience inside of me.
I do it without any conscience inside of me.
Because
I know that to now I'm living a life, a clear life. I'm a child of God who took all of all the filthy garments. The child of God took all of the filthy garments. The child of God throw away all. The child of God go and tell the people that I no longer belong
to.
There's a word of God in Acts chapter 19.
Paul has not preached gospel.
It says Paul went after preaching gospel. All the people that who were holding their earthly things. When they repent, they take all the evil things. They take all the evil things and burn them. The child of God doesn't stay with things of Mikabelo. When we have transformation in your life, you shift all the cockroaches of the devil.
We are sprinkling heaven inside your house, inside your life.
You do a sprinkling heavenly in sprinkling.
That is why the word of God says you become a new creature.
That is why the Bible says you become a new creation.
You can't be new, but you are hidden things.
You can't be new and hidden things.
You can't be new with that hold it there.
You can't be new with things that you stole.
You need to throw away.
You need to throw them away.
And follow the way of Jesus.
And follow the way of Jesus.
Take your cross daily.
Pick up your cross daily.
And follow Jesus.
Follow Jesus.
Because the problem is
the problem is with the children of God.
They can't follow Jesus because
they can't follow Jesus properly with the things they have. They can't take bigger steps. The child of God take the bigger steps.
Because you are free.
Because you are free.
Nothing is surrounding you.
Nothing will hinder you.
Because if there are things, there are obstacles that are surrounding you.
When how can a lady correlate that you surround them?
You'll be walking like this. That is why you see the present day churches.
That is why over Namoni Keregen Zavian.
They sing ha Banigan. Hey, this Fangani we move.
Hey, in this gospel we are moving.
In this gospel you are free.
We are free in this
there
gospel.
There is nothing that is disturbing you.
There is nothing that must disturb
because
us.
Because you have repented.
Because we have repented.
Because you have confessed your sin. How can you confess your sins?
How
can you hear the word of God? And still be the same. You see that there's a problem inside of you. You need to deal with your heart. You need to cry unto the Lord. It is time to take off,
Barabamu.
It doesn't happen that we hear the word of God and remain the same without any transformation. Romans chapter 12, verse 1.
Verse 1.
Do not be conformed to the pattern of this world, but be transformed by the renewal of your mind. What is the pattern of this world? As we can see in the church, how is it? But let us read the word of God in Genesis, Exodus chapter 3.
Exodus chapter 3.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Exodus chapter 3.
Amen.
Hallelujah. Mighty Jesus. Can you read it from, let's start it from verse 1. You can read it from verse 1 until verse 6. Hallelujah.
Exodus chapter 3, verse 1 to 6. On the day Moses was tending the flock of his father-in-law Jethro, the priest of Midian, he led the flock far into the wilderness and came to Sinai, the mountain of God. There, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a blazing fire from the middle of the bush. Moses stared in amazement. Though the bush was engulfed in flames, it didn't burn up. This is amazing, Moses said to himself. Why isn't that bush burning up? I must go see it. When the Lord saw Moses coming to take a closer look, God called him from the middle of the bush. Moses, Moses. Here I am, Moses replied. Do not come any closer. The Lord warned, take off your sandals, for you are standing on holy ground. I am the God of your father, the God of Abraham, the God of Isaac, and the God of Jacob. When Moses heard this, he covered his face because he was afraid to look at God.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
By the time he went to meet the Lord.
He didn't know he will meet God. He didn't know that even the idea that today I will meet God.
But it happened.
But when he was on the mountain,
he saw the burning bush. The word of God says Moses, he was amazed.
Seeing the tree burning, but it wasn't. See the tree burning, but it wasn't.
Hallelujah. The tree was in fire, but it was not burning. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Amen. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. I'm open in my soul. Hallelujah. Mighty Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Amen. Amen. Amen.
Moses saw the tree on fire. He saw the fire, but it was not burning. Because we know that the God that we are praying is a miraculous God. He's not just a God, but he's a God who performs. So what Moses was seeing is a miracle. That is why Moses thought,
and let me take a step closer and see. Because
Because
Because he had the zeal to see what was happening.
The same zealousness that the Lord wants us to have with our lives.
As we pray in the presence of the Lord.
As we live in the presence of the
Lord. The Bible says Moses came
but from. But problem was one.
Mara hunona libo tata bomoa.
That
God saw through Moses.
That is why the Lord says.
That is why Mudimo and
Moses, don't come any closer.
Moses,
don't come any closer.
Atume.
Why would the Lord was stopping Moses?
Why Mudimo and
to come closer to him?
Atume.
Because the Lord saw the sins in Moses. Hallelujah.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah. And Moses.
That is why God said Moses.
Take out your sandals. Take out your sandals. Because the place that we're standing
in,
it's a holy ground. It doesn't happen,
it does not happen.
You can be in a holy ground and not be transformed. Continue going with what you are doing. Continue living the life that you are living. And inside is the presence of the Lord. The Lord doesn't approve it. That is why he said to Moses,
that is why he said to Moses,
but what is happening to the present day church?
Are
they taking off?
Are they taking off? This
cat is a cumulus.
Today's message that the Lord is speaking to us, that we need to take
because
we are in the presence of the Lord.
It doesn't happen.
Hallelujah. Hallelujah.
When we read
this other scripture,
it talks about the woman who was caught in adultery.
She
was caught in doing sin. She was a prostitute woman. She was deep in sin.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. When the Pharisees saw him, they wanted to kill him. According to the law, they took him to Jesus. And when they arrived to Jesus, when they arrived with that woman in front of Jesus, and it doesn't happen you can be in front of Jesus and not be in a holy place. The Bible tells us when they tell Jesus that we have caught this woman doing sin, we found her wanting to sleep with men, so we wanted to kill him. We wanted to kill her. We wanted to end up her life. Jesus didn't say anything. He just looked at them. Because he knew how they are. He knew the way they were living. He knew how they are. They are still rejecting him. He didn't say anything to him. He didn't preach any word to them. The Bible tells us he knelt down and he wrote down.
Atoma agwala hati.
He wrote down.
Amola.
The same hand. The same hand. That Nebuchadnezzar saw.
Nebuchadnezzar
Jesus wrote on the soil. And by writing down,
and
without saying anything, he was touching their conscience.
Saying you must also repent.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
Hallelujah.
Amen.
It doesn't happen to be the present and be the same.
Because their conscience is
spoken. The Bible said that they all left. They all left. And Jesus was left with that woman. Because he is full of mercy.
Because
he is full of grace. He didn't judge that woman. Jesus didn't judge my life. He had mercy on me. He had mercy on that prostitute woman. And he said, today, your sins has been forgiven. Do not sin. The word pierced her heart. The word Jesus pierced her heart. He became transformed.
He
was no longer a prostitute.
A prostitute.
He followed Jesus in righteousness.
He didn't
take on the cleavage anymore. He didn't take out the cleavage anymore. But he served the Lord with humility. Because there was a word that pierced
the heart.
There was a word that penetrated
his heart.
What is the present day church doing today?
It's
the word of God to transform your life. Do you hear the word of the Lord and fill with joy?
Hallelujah.
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 Hallelujah. We bless the Lord so much. We bless the Lord. We thank God for His mercy. We thank God for His grace.
Hallelujah.
Hallelujah. Let us read the word of God in John chapter 11. Jesus. Hallelujah. Is the great God. Almighty Jesus. Let's go to John 11.
John chapter 40. 11, verse
40.
Verse 40. John chapter
11. Go 38. Amen.
John chapter 11 from verse 38.
Amen.
Jesus, once more deeply moved, came to the tomb. It was a cave with a stone laid across the entrance. Take away the stone, he said. But Lord, said Martha, the sister of the dead man, by this time there is bad odor, for he had been there for 4 days. Then Jesus said, did I not tell you that if you believe, you will see the glory of God? So they took away the stone. Then Jesus looked up and said, Father, I thank you that you have heard me.
The word of the Lord says, hallelujah. Jesus instructed them to take the stone. Jesus said to them, take off the stone.
As we know how the olden days graves
They were buried in cages.
They would put stones.
But
at that time when Lazarus was dead, the Lord Jesus wanted to reveal his greatness. It's not because he did not know that Lazarus is dead.
He knew everything. But because he wanted to reveal his glory.
All those who did not believe. Even when the disciples told him,